In this episode, we'll visit the epic Lóndrangar sea stacks in the Snæfellsnes peninsula, and I'll share some tips and reasons on why and how to use a wide-angle lens.
I think it's worth it. Incredible light. I'm literally on top of the world.
The 75 and 61 meter tall pair of basalt cliffs, Lóndrangar, are an iconic site of the Snæfellsnes Peninsula. Lóndrangar is located along the coast, only 9 kilometers from the town of Arnarstapi, which we visited in episode 14. The cliffs have been formed due to being of harder materials, where the surrounding rock has been eroded away over the millennia. Whether you come from north or east, you cannot miss these lone towering rocks on the flat volcanic plains. Of course, unless you are having a complete whiteout of snow, which does happen from time to time. We'll start west of Lóndrangar. To find the parking lot, just drive towards the lighthouse. There is only one road leading to the lighthouse, so it shouldn't be too hard to find. Find your parking spot and follow the trails towards the cliffs.
So yesterday, the 31st of March, we had high sun, clear weather, 10 degrees. Today, not so much. 1st of April, I don't know if the weather is playing an April's fool on me. It's probably just Iceland. So I come down here to the western side of Lóndrangar, and it's actually a place which is worth checking out because there's a lot of interesting foregrounds down here along the shoreline with like crude black lava rocks. So that should be good potential today, and especially with weather like this, gives it like a very moody feeling which accompanies the black roughness of the lava. Very, very good. Okay, so a little tip in regards to opening your backpack when it's a weather like this. You can see the wind is from behind, so we have the snow coming this way. And it is to open the backpack so that the back piece is against the wind, protects the inner parts of the bag from the wind. Of course, don't let it be open all the time, but it's a nice little tip to just like open it fast and without having to worry too much about snow and rain and moist in the backpack itself. So I found this composition here. We have like a crack leading through the photo and up to the cliffs. And I really like how the snow just like comes towards me here. It's like it adds a lot to the scene, and like I can even make leading lines or visual flow with the snow leading into the scene. So it's quite a unique photo, I think. I most certainly haven't tried taking a picture like this before. In regards to the settings, I just put it on f16, so I don't have to focus stack it. I've focused like about one third into the scene. Well, that's not right. It's like 2 meters into the scene. ISO 100, and I end up with a shutter speed of 1/4 of a second. And it gives some nice streaks in the photo. Quite unique, quite interesting. So if you followed my channel for a while, you would know by now that I really love using wide angles. I really love that dramatic effect between the foreground and the background, often because the elements in the foreground are fairly small compared to what I have in the background. So using a wide angle, you can really enlarge the foregrounds and really put a lot of emphasis on it, making it lead into the scene. So you also have a huge amount of depth in your photos, which really creates this 3D effect, as if the viewer were actually standing in the scene. You can almost like feel the foreground. So dependent on the scene I'm photographing, I'm usually pointing the camera 30 degrees down. And if I have it vertical, it's often even more, like 45, 50 degrees down. And it really elongates the foreground, like dragging it into the scene because of the lens distortion. So for the most part, I have been using my 16 to 35 to create most of my long exposures. And it's a really versatile lens. And for some reason for Iceland, it's like my main go-to lens all the time. Like, I really love the focal length up here of 16 to 20. For some reason, it just works with a lot of the different locations up here. So it's all about getting down close to the ground and getting close to your foreground subject or object. Because from the perspective of your camera, the foreground will be way larger. It's the same as if I have my finger here, and compared to the background mountains, the finger is huge. Obviously, if I had a long enough arm so that I could take it all the way over to the mountain, the finger would be very, very small. So this is how you can play with perspective to create this illusion of a big foreground and create this 3D effect. The closer the camera is to the foreground, the bigger the relative depth of field in your scene will be, which means that you will have to have a small aperture to get everything in focus unless you focus stack. Normally, I prefer to have a small aperture because this specific lens suffers from focus breathing. So when I focus, it adjusts the focal length, which makes stitching your different pictures together in Photoshop afterwards a bit hard.
This entire area is full of interesting foregrounds, which all are worth exploring and comes alive in different ways dependent on the weather. When I had finished up here, I went to the regular vantage point west of Lóndrangar. This parking lot is even easier to find as it is next to the main road, which is leading around the Snæfellsnes peninsula.
There really isn't anything like a wet windbreaker that makes you look like a sad person. So I've come here to the viewpoint towards Lóndrangar, and it's an obvious location for wide angle with some nice foregrounds leading into the scene and to Lóndrangar, which is the focal point of the scene.
From the parking lot, there is one trail leading towards the vantage point. The trail does divide into two, but as it's a round trip, it doesn't matter which one you choose. For me, 16mm is a great focal length for this location, but if you want to zoom in, be sure to also bring a long lens. In the start of October and start of March, you will be able to photograph the sunset straight behind the cliffs, which looks absolutely amazing. And all through the winter half of the year, you will get Lóndrangar lit by the rising sun. That is, of course, only if clouds won't obscure the light. Iceland being Iceland, I, of course, had to endure the start of a snowstorm to record this video. I had, however, visited this location several times during winter.
So I walked a little bit down to find this location here. And as a wide angle location, it works really, really well. I'm shooting at 16mm. I have like the edge down here of the grass leading all the way up, creating like a circle, which leads up, a half circle, which leads up and into Lóndrangar. It's a really cool location. I am shooting it at a slow shutter speed as to smooth the water out just a tad bit. And then I'm also shooting one with a fast shutter speed as to freeze the seagulls, because I really like the seagulls, how they fly around. But I also want the water to be a little bit smooth. That's at least the plan. I don't know how the final picture will turn out. But as you can see, I'm pointing the camera around 40 degrees down as to get the foreground and not so much of the sky. Because right now the sky is really boring, there's really nothing there, it's just a whiteout because of all the snow. The snow and the atmosphere, like, gives a lot to the picture. So it's not that I don't like it, it's just I don't want to just show a blank sky in this particular photo.
A bit further up the trail, there is also another vantage point which is definitely worth checking out. Since I flew my drone in Iceland this winter, it has come to my attention that drones for recreational use, aka hobbyists, are not allowed to fly their drones in the national parks of Iceland. So shame on me for not knowing that, and don't fly your drones here as Lóndrangar is a part of the Snæfellsnes National Park. At some places you can however obtain a permit, or if you are Hollywood and have a lot of money, you can of course also be allowed. This was actually the very last location I visited this winter. It is, however, not the last location I'll show you from my winter tour, as I'm not releasing these videos in the chronological order by which they were recorded. As mentioned earlier, the day before the weather had been beautiful. Blue skies, few clouds, and a relative high temperature for Iceland in the very end of March. The day after, where I recorded this video, a major snowstorm hit Iceland. The snow you've seen in this video was actually only the very first part of that snowstorm. Within a day, 30 to 40 centimeters of snow fell out of the clouds. Me being in a camper van, dug in for the rest of the day and night and waited it out. The following day I started a somewhat skeptical drive towards Reykjavik. Luckily the snowplow cleared the road around midday, making the drive way easier. On my way I of course had to get some photographs of the beautiful new winter landscape. Even though my amount of subscribers are soon to hit the 20,000, which is just absolutely awesome, the amount of views I get on my videos has ironically slowly declined. If you want a notification for whenever I upload a new video, you can either subscribe to my newsletter in the description below or hit the bell button next to the subscription button, also below. As always, I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, I'd highly appreciate both a like and a comment.